This stuff some soldiers sling around about America wanting to stay out of the war, not wanting to fight, it's a lot of baloney. Americans love to fight, traditionally. All real Americans love the sting and the clash of the battle. America loves a winner. America will not tolerate a loser. That's why America has never lost and will never lose a war. You're not all going to die. Only 2% of you, right here today, will be killed in a major battle. Death must not be feared. Death in time comes to all of us. And every man is scared of his first action. If he says he's not, he's a liar. Some men are cowards, yes, but they fight just the same. The real hero is the man who will fight even though he's scared. Why?
Some get over their fright in
a minute under fire. Others, an hour. And for some, even days. But a real man will never let the fear of death overpower his honor, his sense of duty, to his country and to his manhood. All through your Army careers, you've been crying about your drills. That, like everything else in the Army, has its definite purpose. That purpose is constant alertness, to create and maintain constant alertness. This must be bred into every soldier. If not, some German will sneak up behind him. There are 400 neatly marked graves somewhere in Sicily, all because one man went to sleep on his job. But they are German graves because we caught them asleep! An army is a team. Lives, sleeps, fights, and eats as a team. This individual hero stuff is a lot of baloney. It's a lot of garbage. Every man in the Army plays a vital role. Every man has his job to do and must do it. What if every truck driver decided he didn't like the whine of the shell overhead, turned yellow, and jumped headlong into a ditch? What then? What if every man thought, they won't miss me, I'm just one of millions? Where would we be? Where would our country, our loved ones, our homes, even the world be? No, thank God, Americans don't think like that. Every man does his job and serves the whole. Ordnance men supply and maintain the vast machinery of this war to keep us rolling. Quartermasters bring up clothes and food. Every last KP has his job to do, even the guy that boils the water to keep us from getting sick. Remember, men, no mention of this is to be made in any letters. I'm not supposed to be here. I'm not even supposed to be commanding this army. The USA is supposed to be wondering what happened to me. We want to get this thing over with and get out of here. Now, let the first people find out be the Germans. I want them to look up and howl. Ah! It's the Third Army of Patton again! We want to get this thing over with and get out of here. The shortest road home is through Berlin and Tokyo. We'll win this war and we'll win it by showing the enemy that we have more guts than they have or ever will have. There's one great thing you can say when this is all over with and you're home once more. When you're sitting by the fireside 30 years from now, you can thank God. With your grandson on your knee, you can thank God when he looks up and asks you what you did in the war. You won't have to shift him to the other knee, cough, and say, I shoveled dirt in Louisiana.
Thank you.